Hello everyone and welcome to today's tutorial. In this video we are going to learn about counter operations in TIA portal. In TIA we have three types of counters. If we click on instructions and then counter operations, you see up counter, down counter and up down counter. They are used to count the number of an event in our program. The first counter is up counter, CTU. Let's say for instance I want to count up the number of times an input 0 goes to 1, and then when it's repeated 5 times I want to turn on an output. For this purpose we can use the up counter. Let's see what we have in this counter. I insert it into our program. You see, like timers, TIA portal needs to define an instance data block to save the data of the counter, such as the status of input and output. Determine a name for the counter and hit OK. This counter counts up by 1 when the signal state at the input parameter changed from 0 to 1. So when the input CU detects a positive signal H, the current counter value at the CV will be incremented by 1. I insert a normal contact as a counter input, I0.0. We have here a reset input. If we give a signal here, the current value will be 0. PV or preset value is the upper limit for incrementing of current value and determining the signal state at the output. I give it, for example, 4. If the current value is greater than or equal to the value of the PV, the Q output will be on. I'm going to put an output here. CV shows which value the counter has currently. It's an integer value, so I use a word. By default, format of numbers is integer. Here you can change the number format. The difference between these formats are the range and also number of bit memory that they use. For example, double integer needs 4 bytes, so I need here modify mWord to mDoubleWord. Let's simulate the program. The current value of the counter is 0. As you see, with each change of signal state in counter input, the CV will be incremented. Once the CV gets 4, the output will be on. On the next one, the preset and current values will be equal and the output will turn on. With reset, the CV will be 0 and output will be again off. As long as the reset input is activated, the change of signal state at the input has no effect. You can see also the counter value here at the top of the counter. Or if you open the data block for this counter, you can also see all the values here. Alright, the next timer is the countdown, CTD. Suppose this time we need to count down when we press the input. In this case, we can use the countdown counter. The only difference is that when the signal stays at the CD input changed from 0 to 1, the current counter value at the CV output will be decremented by 1 until 0. For example, I want to decrement the count from 4 to 0 with each activation of the input CD. PV is 4. Input LD load this value in the CV. Without activation of this input, the value of PV will not be loaded to the CV. CV gets decremented by 1 starting with PV until 0 is reached. Output Q gets true as soon as CV is 0. Let me download the program. As you see, the output is on because I have not loaded PV value and CV is 0. Now CV is 4 and the output is off. Each time I press the input CD, the counter value is decremented until 0. Now the current counter value is again equal to 0 and the Q output is on. The third counter is up-down counter. This counter is a combination of both count-up and down counters. It can be used to increase or decrease the current value. So we have two inputs. CU will increment the CV and CD will decrement it. This makes the value of CV 0. Load count is exactly like the LD in the countdown counter. It copies the value of PV in the current value. The output Q U is for counting up and will be true when the current value reaches the preset value. An output QD for counting down returns true when the CV has been decremented to zero or less. I'm going to simulate the counter. Each time by pressing the counter up, the current value will be increased. Now CV is equal to PV and output up is true. I make a reset. Now CV is zero, so this time output down is true. I load the PV in CV. Again, output up is on because the CV is equal to PV. Each time by pressing the counter down, CV will be decreased, and when it is zero, QD will be true. Okay, that was all about counters in TIA Portal, and you can now use them in your program. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was helpful for you. If you have any question, please don't hesitate to write a comment below. See you next video.